Do you want an easy way to add menu icons to your menu area? Well, keep watching. In this video, I'll show you how you can add menu icons in WordPress. I'll show you two methods, and the first one's the easiest of the two. With the first method, we'll be installing a plugin that will allow us to do all of this easily. So let's head over to our WordPress dashboard. We'll go down to plugins area. Add new, and we want to search for menu image. This is the one we want. So let's go ahead and click install now. And once it's installed, you'll also want to make sure that you click activate as well. Once it's activated, we can head over to our menu area. So let's go to appearance, menus. You see with my home area, I can extend, I can expand that. And here I have a button that I can click to set the image. You can either choose the image that you have already, or you can upload files of the icons that you already have. So you want to go through this and do it for each one. Also, for the image size, you want to make sure that you select it for the appropriate size. I have set these for 24 by 24, so you'll want to adjust that as well. Down here, you can choose to hide the title of the menu item or the page, or you can decide to put it above, below, before, or after. I'm going to keep it at after. And then you just want to go through and do the same thing for all of them. Great. When you're finished adding all of the icons, you want to make sure that you click Save Menu. And now we'll go to our website and we'll see what it looks like in action. Now we have great looking icons set up for our menu page. So that's method one. For method two, if you're more comfortable with using CSS, then I'll show you how to do that. So let's head back over to our WordPress dashboard. I'm going to go ahead and remove that plugin. So I've removed the plugin because we're going to use some CSS instead. So for this, let's head back over to our appearance area, menus. Again, we'll be using the main menu for this. So click on it and you'll see that that button and the icons are gone because I removed the plugin. That's all right. What we want to do is we want to go up to see screen options. And from here, we want to make sure that we select the CSS classes because we'll be using that for these. So we can close that out. I have that button selected. And now we have CSS classes, which is optional in our area. What I want to do here is create new CSS classes and type them here. And then I'll show you how we can add that in our CSS. And you'll want a separate one for each. You want to make sure that you click Save Menu. Great. Now that we've added the CSS classes, we'll also need to add some bit of code to our CSS style sheet. You can grab the CSS code from the link below. The easiest way that you can do this is head over to the customize area that's just above menu. We'll click customize. And your theme will look a little bit different with this, but you'll want to scroll all the way down and you'll see this little additional CSS here. You probably don't have any information here, but just scroll all the way down and get a new line. And we'll want to paste this bit of code. So basically we're doing home icon and here's the background image where it's at. You'll want to grab this information. I'll show you how to do that. And you want to make sure it says no repeat and all of that. You can do the same thing for all of them, changing the CSS name from all of them from the ones that we gave in the menu. I want to get the location of all the images. So I'm going to open up a new tab. I don't want to close that other one out. So open up a new tab, go to my dashboard, head down to media. I'm going to use all the icons that I just used. I've already uploaded these. To get the location, you want to click on it. And then over here, you see the URL. We just want to select the whole thing and click copy. This one is my about. So I want to go back to the CSS area, find the about icon, and I want to change this out. So I'm going to paste that in there. So we'll just do it for all of the others. And now when all of those are in there, you see them showing up here. So we can make sure that we click publish. And now we can click on our blog and see it in action as well. So those are two great methods to add menu icons in your WordPress website. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.